So this is the current in the Norton equivalent, and the resistance here, which is the Thevenin equivalent, is the ratio of VOC by ISC. So R Thevenin is equal to minus alpha beta V1 minus alpha V2 divided by beta minus alpha into R4 Do you agree or not? Is there any minus problem? No problem. Okay. This is a beautiful expression we got finally, that the Thevenin resistance is given by this. Remember, the ratio of alpha is equal to R2 by R1 by R2, and beta is equal to if alpha is equal to beta, then what happened to this? Infinity. So you get an ideal current source. Okay. What is alpha is equal to beta means? R1 by R2 must be equal to R3 by R4, or R1 R4 must be equal to R3 R2. R1 R4 must be equal to R2 R3. If you can make this resistor such satisfying this relation, I am able to get an exactly a current source, ideal current source, with whose value is equal to V2 minus V1 divided by 1 and 1 by this. So I am able to convert two voltages V1 and V2 in terms of to a current source, controlled current source, whose is proportional to difference between V1 and V2. If alpha is greater than beta, then the current source will have positive resistance, which will not be an ideal current source, will be a non-ideal current source. If alpha is less than beta, what happens? Then at those terminals you have a negative resistance here. There is a concept of the negative resistance, something to keep in mind, that within a range of voltages and current operation, the ratio of the incremental value of the characteristic could have a negative slope. For example, if you have a characteristic something like this, VI characteristic, is positive slope, positive slope, but here there's a, like, it can't be happening for all range of I's and V's, but a small amount of range of I and V, there can be a negative slope. And there are devices which provide you a negative resistance over a region of V's and I's, or, like, for example, tunnel diode, or you can connect circuits in a particular manner which will provide you the negative resistance. Remember that it happened because of this fellow here. If you are not fed back to the positive terminal, you never will get a negative resistance, because of this positive feedback connected to the plus terminal gives you the negative resistance. This negative resistance is a very important idea. For example, V1 and V2, even if you make it zero, and then this becomes equal to zero, but this will still remain same value, some value, and it just gives a pure resistance, negative resistance. So the idea of this whole idea of negative resistance is emanated only because of this positive feedback you have connected at this plus terminal. Very unusual behavior of this circuit. You will do this experiment in the lab, ideal way of doing this experiment is to put a capacitor here and observe the voltage across the capacitor. As a current source, charging this capacitor, when this ideal current source, the voltage will be linear. The integral ID is equal to V, so it should be straight line. If this is a pure positive resistance, then it will be exponential function, right? And if it's negative, then you get the slope other way around. You can actually see it happening in the laboratory by observing the voltage here, the effect of this negative resistance. Electrical engineers somehow don't use the word Howland too frequently. They don't ever call it a Howland current source. But physicists always use the word Howland current source. So this word is not too commonly used by electrical engineers, but he was the one who invented the circuit called the Howland current source. This is a voltage controlled current source. Now you can make V10, V20 or some whichever way you want, you can get the general current to control. Sometimes this is also known as transconductance amplifier. Because VCCS is nothing but a transconductance, right? Voltage converted to current. So there's a transconductance only, which converts the voltage to a current or mutual admittance, whichever way you want to call it. So this technically sometimes people call this as a transconductance amplifier. People also sometimes if you connect something between the two terminals, output and the input negative terminal, put some load, the current through this is equal to this voltage divided by this resistance, same current has to flow through this. So people sometimes use this as a, you also call it as a transconductance amplifier. But this current that is flowing through this is not a ideal current source. Just a thumb resist V1 by R1 is flowing through this. We are not feeding this load by a constant current source. It's not an exact current source, but the current will be equal to V1 by R1. So sometimes they use this circuit, also call it as a transconductance amplifier. But ideal transconductance amplifier is this, which really represents a current source. Transfer voltage to current. Under the condition, this into this is equal to this into this. You may have to do a bit of trimming to make sure that R1 into R4 is equal to R3 into R2, because you put those four resistors, physical resistors may not have exact value. So people put a small potentiometer here and trim it to adjust the values so that this product is equal to this product.